Assalamu alaikum students. Today we will discuss the MCQs of chapter 7 oscillation physics. Let's start. First MCQ. Simple harmonic motion must be periodic only, vibratory only, A is directly proportional to displacement in opposite direction, all ABC. So here option D is correct. Simple harmonic motion must be vibratory, must be periodic. What is periodic motion? The motion that repeats itself in equal interval of time. So this one is a condition of SHM. Next, vibratory only. It is the to and fro motion. This one is also the condition for SHM. A is directly proportional to displacement but in opposite direction. This one is also correct condition for SHM. So here option D is correct. Second, the equation for a body executing simple harmonic motion is, here we know that A is directly proportional to negative displacement, which means opposite direction. So we will place here the constant. So we place here omega square x. So here option B is correct. Okay. Look at the third one. Hooke's law correlates the, here the D is correct, stress and strain. Hooke's law says that stress is directly proportional to the strain, or stress is equal to E and strain. So this is the modified form of Hooke's law, and it correlates the stress and strain. Now look at here. Let's suppose it's a body like something. If we apply a force on it, then what will happen? Here, its length will change, okay? Its size and length will change. And here, the extension will occur, okay? Extension will occur in this body from here to here. When we apply force, the extension will occur. So, what is extension? Extension is actually strain, okay? Strain. What is strain? Strain is the extension in length per unit length, okay? Per original length. So, this is the strain occur in when we apply the force on it. Now, look at here. When we apply the force and the strain occur, then what will happen? Then the molecules and the atoms of this body will attract each other, okay? In turn, they will attract each other and they will exert force. So in that case, what will happen? The restoring force will occur in it. When the restoring force will occur, the body will come to its original position. And in that restoring force is called stress, okay? That restoring force is stress. So stress is the force per unit area. The restoring force per unit area is called stress, okay? When we apply the force, strain occur, then what will happen? The atoms of this body will attract each other, atoms or molecules. When they attract each other, then what will happen? The restoring force will produce in it. When restoring force produce, the body will come to its original position. And this restoring force is called stress. So that's why we say that stress is directly proportional to the strain, okay? Stress is directly proportional to the strain. We say that stress is dependent on strain. When strain occur, the stress will occur, okay? When strain increases, the stress will increase, okay? So it means that stress is dependent on strain. And this stress is the restoring force on a body. Like, we say that when the strain occur, then what will happen after this? The stress will occur. Now, in this stress, our restoring force. Restoring force is equal to the applied force, okay? This restoring force is equal to the applied force. Now, here we say that stress is directly proportional to strain, or stress is equal to E into strain. And this is modulus of elasticity, okay? This is the proportionality constant or modulus of elasticity. So it's the modern form of Hooke's law. Hooke's law correlates the stress and the strain. Okay, and keep one thing in your mind, that this stress is the restoring force produced in the body when we applied force on it. Okay, so this stress is the restoring force. And how this restoring force produce? Now, this restoring force produces when we applied a force on the body. Then what will happen? These molecules displace from its original place, okay, displaced from its original place, due to which they lose its equilibrium. In order to gain the equilibrium and gain its original place, these atoms attract each other. And when they attract each other, then after removal of this applied force, they regain its original position. And that's why, and this is what the restoring force produces. So now the fourth one. 100 gram mass attached to the end of the suspended spring stretches the spring by 3 centimeters, okay? If the mass is replaced by 200 gram mass, then the spring will be stretched further by. Now look at here, a mass of 100 gram stretches the spring by 3 cm. Then if we replace the mass by 200 gram, then this further stretching, it means that apart from 3 cm, what will be the further stretching in the spring? So let's solve this one. Look here, we have to find the x2. Now how we will find? We know that here f2 divided by f1 is equal to kx2 divided by kx1. Okay, here k spring constant is same, okay, only the mass is changed here, so it means that they will cancel each other. Now look at here, we know that f is equal to mg, so m2g divided by m1g is equal to x divided by x2 divided by x1. Now the gravity is same for both, which means that g will cancel each other. Now look at here, m2 divided by m1 is equal to x2 divided by x1. Here we know that m2 is 200 gram and what m1 is 100 gram, so this will cancel each other, these zeros, and g will also cancel, okay. So x2 divided by, what is x1? It's 3 centimeter, okay. X2 is equal to 2 multiplied by 3, so it will give the answer of 6 centimeter. Now look at the MCQ. They have stated that apart from 3 centimeter, how much will be the further stretching, okay. If the mass is replaced 200 gram, then the spring will be stretched further, okay. Here what is mean by further? It means that apart from 3 centimeter, how much stretching will occur in the spring by replacing the mass. So look at here, it means that 6 centimeter minus 3 centimeter, it is the stretching in x, it is x2 minus x1, okay. So it will give 3 centimeter. So here the answer is 3 centimeter, further stretching will occur 3 centimeter. So here is 3 centimeter answer. Fifth, if the time period of a spring mass system is this one, 2 by m divided by k, and x is the extension produced from the mean position, okay, then the time period in the terms of x, now look at the time period in terms of x. Now look at here, the time period is 2 by under root m divided by k, okay. Here we know that f is equal to kx and k is equal to f divided by x. Now put here k is equal to f divided by x, okay. And we also know that f is equal to mg. Look, this x will come here, okay. Now 2 pi mx divided by f, we know that f is equal to mg. Now write it like this, t is equal to 2 pi mx divided by mg, okay. So this m will cancel this one, so the time period in term of x will be 2 pi under root x divided by g. So this one will be the time period in terms of x. Look at the sixth one. A mass attached to the spring executing simple harmonic motion completes 50 vibrations in 25 seconds. The frequency of vibration of a spring. Here we know that frequency is equal to vibration per second, okay. Now what is the vibration? It is 50 vibrations divided by 25. Now the frequency will be 2 hertz, okay. The answer will be 2 hertz. So here 2 hertz is the answer. Look at the seventh one. The potential energy of mass executing simple harmonic motion at when displacement is equal to amplitude, okay, is k. So the potential energy is k when x is equal to x naught. Now the required is what? The potential energy of mass at twice amplitude from mean position. Now we have to find the potential energy when the amplitude is twice from mean position. Now look at here. We know that potential energy is equal to 1 over 2 kx square. It is the potential energy at any instant of displacement, okay. At any displacement, the potential energy can be found from this formula. Now the first case is that the potential energy is k when the displacement is equal to x naught. Now look, x is equal to x naught, so potential energy will be k is equal to 1 over 2 k x naught square, okay. Now the next part is that the potential energy of mass at twice amplitude from mean position. Now take the amplitude as twice, okay, x naught is equal to 2x naught. Now look, the potential energy is equal to k 2x naught square. Take the square here, so you will get 4x naught square. Look at here. Now bring this 4 above the 2, okay. So look at here, it will be like this, 4 1 over 2 k x naught square. Now we know that this term is equal to k, okay, this term is equal to k. Now put potential energy is equal to 4k. So when we increase the, when we twice the amplitude from mean position, then what happen? The potential energy will be equal to the 4 times of the original potential energy, okay. It will be equal to the 4 times of the potential energy at amplitude. Look at here, when the amplitude is 1 time, then the potential energy is equal to k. When the amplitude is 2 times, then the potential energy is equal to 4k. So this one is the answer. 8. The instantaneous velocity of a body executing simple harmonic motion. So here we know that this one is the formula of instantaneous velocity. v is equal to omega under root x naught square minus x, where this one term is amplitude and this one is displacement. So option C is correct here. These formulas are derived in your book, okay, so you should learn it from there. Next, 9 number. A mass of 2 kg stretches the spring by 2 cm. The spring constant of the spring is. Now look at here, you have to find the spring constant, okay? We know that according to Hooke's law, F is equal to kx and k is equal to F divided by x. And we also know that F is equal to mg, okay? Now mg divided by x. Now took F 2 multiplied by 10, okay? So the x will be here 0.02 meter, okay? When you convert this 2 centimeter into meter, you will get 0.02 meter. Now you will get mg as 20 and divided by 0.02 meter. Now look at here, if I move this one point here 1 and 2, then I have to move this one also like 1 and 2, and in loops put 0 here, okay? Now it will be like 2000 divided by 2. Now do cutting here, 2 ones are 2 and 2 ones are 2, so 2 zeros are 0. So the k will be 1000 newton per meter. So this one is the spring constant here. The spring constant k depend upon the length and the stiffness of our spring, applied force, displacement from mean position. Now look at here, the spring constant k depend on the length and the stiffness of a spring. Now let's suppose you have two springs. This one is of length smaller and this one is like here, okay? Now feel that if you have this one spring, then you have to apply greater force in order to stretch this one, okay? And if you have this one, the length is greater here, so you have to apply a smaller force in order to stretch this one spring. So it means that the spring constant depends upon the length of the spring. Look at here, stiffness of a spring. Stiffness means that the two different spring, like I take two springs of same length, okay, but the material is different here, like this one is made of hard material and this one is made of soft, okay? So it means that this one will require greater force in order to stretch, okay? And this one will require smaller force in order to stretch it, okay? Now it means that the spring constant depends upon the length and the stiffness of a spring. So here option A is correct. 11th, the spring constant of a spring is K. If the spring is cut into two halves, then the spring constant of one half is. Now look at here, this one example. If I have this spring and the spring constant is equal to 2, okay? If I cut this spring into two parts, then what will happen? This one spring and the new spring constant of this one and this one will be. Now look at here, k is equal to, we know that k is equal to fx, f divided by x, okay? Then k nu, this is just a dash, okay? K nu is equal to f divided by, so I divide it into two parts, so x divided by 2, okay? If I bring this one 2 here, then it will become 2 f divided by x. And I know that this one is equal to k, okay? So put here k instead of this one, okay? So k nu will be equal to 2 times of the k. So it means that the k nu k will be 2 times of the original spring constant. But if I divide it into 3 parts, then what will happen? The nu k will be equal to 3 times of the original k. If I divide it into 4 parts, then the nu k will be equal to 4 times of the original k. But keep one thing in your mind, that you have to cut this into equal parts. Like this formula, k is equal to, k nu is equal to nk. N is the number of parts in which you cut the spring, okay? This formula is only valid for that one spring which you cut into equal parts, okay? Not into unequal parts. You have to cut the spring into equal parts, then this one formula is valid, okay? So here the answer will be 2k. Now look at the 12th one. The time period of spring mass system is T. If the spring is cut into 4 pieces, then the time period of each piece will be. So first we have to find the new spring constant when we cut it into 4 pieces. Is equal to K, okay? Spring constant is equal to K. Now look at here, we know that K is equal to F divided by X. But if I divide this spring into 4 equal parts, look, equal parts, okay? If I divide it into 4 equal parts, then what will happen? The new spring constant of individual spring will be F divided by X over 4, okay? We have divided into 4 equal parts, so it will be X divided by 4. Now bring this X here, so it will be 4 F divided by X, okay? Now we know that F divided by X is equal to K, so the new spring constant will be 4 times of the original spring constant. Okay, here in MCQ they have cut the spring into four pieces. So Knu is equal to Nk, where N is 4 here, okay? So it is the 4 times of the original spring constant. But here we have to find the time period, okay? The time period of the each piece, okay? We have to find the time period of each piece. Now find it like this. T is equal to 2 pi m divided by k, okay? It is the time period of the original spring. If we divide the spring into 4 equal pieces, then what will happen? The time period will be 2 pi m divided by 4k, okay? Time period will be m under root m divided by 4k. Now next, if I take the root on 4, then what will happen? It will be like 2 pi 1 over 2 under root m divided by k. Now look, we know that 2 pi m divided by k is equal to this one, t, okay? So what will happen? T nu will be equal to t original divided by time, okay? So it means that if we cut the spring into 4 equal pieces, then the time period of each spring will be half of the original time period, okay? So it means that the time period will decreases, okay? Because the original time period, the new time period is the half of the original time period. So this one is the answer here. 14. The elastic potential energy of a system executing simple harmonic motion is E. If the displacement is quadruple, then the elastic potential energy become. So when the original elastic potential energy is E, if the displacement is 4 times of the original displacement, then what will happen to the elastic potential energy? We know that potential energy is equal to 1 over 2 kx square, and also here elastic potential energy is equal to 1 over 2 kx square, okay? Here when we increase the displacement into 4 times, then what will happen? New elastic potential energy will be 1 over 2 k 4 times of the displacement and x square. Now take the square here. It will be 1 over 2 k 16, 4 is 16, x square, okay? Now the new elastic potential will be 16 multiply 1 over 2 kx square, and we know that this one term is equal to here E, okay, original E. Now the new elastic potential energy will be 16 times of the original elastic potential energy. When we increase the displacement 4 times, then the new elastic potential will be 16 times of the original potential energy. So this one is the answer. Next, a spring mass system executes simple harmonic motion. If 1 kg load is added to it, then the time period of spring mass system will be. Now look, we know that time period is equal to 2 pi m divided by k in case of spring mass system. So if we increase the mass, then what will happen? The time period will also increase. So here option A is correct, okay? Now look at 16. A 0.5 kg mass attached to an elastic spring of stiffness, this one, okay, executes simple harmonic motion. The angular velocity of the system will be. Now look at here. We know that in case of SHM, the angular velocity in case of SHM and spring mass system, okay, what will happen? The angular velocity of the system is equal to under root k divided by m. K is the spring constant and m is the mass. Now here given is the k, 0.005 newton into meter, and mass is 0.5 kg, okay? Now write it here like 0.5 multiply 10 power minus 2. Move this point here 1 and 2 and write it here 10 power minus 2. Now cancel these two, so you will get under root 10 multiply 10 power minus 2, okay? Now here is minus 2, okay? So I can write it like 1 over 10 power positive 2. If I move there and bring it in denominator, it will be like 1 over 10 power 2. Now under root can be written as 1 over 2, okay? Now cross this 1 over 2 with this 2, so you will get 1 over 10. And when we divide 1 divided 1, when we divide 1 in 10, then you will get 0.1 radian per second. So here the angular velocity is 0.1 radian per second. Now look at 17 number. The time period of a simple pendulum is T. Okay, time period is T. If the length of pendulum is decreased by 36%, then the time period becomes. Now let's find the time period. Now look at the MCQ. The original time period is T, and its length must be 100%, okay? Its length must be 100%. So if we decrease the length by 36%, so what does it mean? That the length is now 64%. Look, 100 minus 36 is 64%. And here is, if the length is decreased by 36%, which means that the length, when we subtract 36 from 100%, then we will get 64% length, okay? So here the length is 64%, because from 100% they have decreased 36%, and we will get 64%. Now look at here. T2 divided by T1 is equal to L2 divided under root L2 divided by L1. So you can write it like this, okay? Under root L2 divided by L1. And here we know that L2 is 64% and L1 is 100%, okay? L2 is 64% and L1 is 100%. From MCQ, we can derive this like L1 is 100%, okay? Because they have said that they have decreased 36% the length. So it means that the original length must be 100%. Now, let's take the under root of this one, okay? So if we take the under root, you will get 8 divided by 10. And by division, the answer will be 0.8. Now bring this t here in multiplication side. So t2 will be 0.8 t1, okay? This will be the answer of simple pendulum when the length is decreased 36%, okay? The time period of simple pendulum when the length is decreased 36%. So you will get this one answer. T2 will be 0.8 of the t1. The time period of simple pendulum of length 100 cm is t. If the length of pendulum is increased to 400 cm, then the percent change in t will be. Now look at here. Here the length is 100 cm and the time period is t. So when the length is increased to 400 cm, then the percent change in time period is required. Now here we know that t2 divided by t1 is equal to under root L2 divided by L1. So here 400 cm, L2 is 400 cm and L1 is 100 cm. So this will cancel, this one and this 0 will cancel each other. You will get 4 divided by 1, okay? Now taking square root, so you will get 2 divided by 1, or T2 is equal to 2 times of the T1. Now look at here. You don't need to convert this centimeter into meter because in case of ratio, the units will cancel each other. So it will not affect the value of this time period, okay? Now, in order to find the percent change, what you have to do, take this 2 and write it here and subtract 1 from this 2. Subtract 1 from this 2 and multiply it with 100%. So you will get the answer 100%. So here the percent change in time period is 100%. So this one is the answer. 19. The tension in the string of simple pendulum is minimum 8. Here we know that tension is minimum at extreme position. Because, now look at here, mean position. On mean position, the tension is equal to weight. The tension is applied on whole weight, okay? Like, this one is tension on mean position and this one will be the direction of weight. But it's in case of extreme position, the upward force, tension, we can call this tension is upward force, okay? The tension is only applied to the W cos theta, okay? So that's why only one component will contribute to the tension. The only one component of the weight will contribute to the tension, while the other component contribute to the restoring force. So it means that tension is minimum at extreme position. Now look at the 20. The acceleration of a simple harmonic motion of a simple pendulum at extreme position. So here acceleration of simple pendulum at extreme position is, we know that acceleration is equal to negative omega square x naught. X naught is the displacement, okay? And we also know that in case of simple pendulum, this omega is equal to g divided by l, okay? And here x naught will come in its place, okay? So look at the option C, a is equal to minus g x naught divided by l. But here in case of mass spring system, keep one thing in your mind that in case of mass spring system, omega square will be equal to k divided by m, okay? It is only for your knowledge. So here the answer is C. 21. The time period of second pendulum is, we know that it's 2 seconds, okay? 22. The frequency of spring mass system suspended from some support is f. Frequency is f. If the spring is reduced to 1/4 of its initial length, then the frequency will be. Now look at here. What they have done? They have taken the spring from this one system, okay? Where the frequency is f. And they divided the spring into 4th equal pieces, okay? And they took one spring from that pieces, and now the required is find the frequency of that one spring. So we know that k is equal to nk, okay? K nu is equal to nk. So here the answer will be 4k. Now let's find the frequency. Now look, the original frequency is 1 over 2 pi under root k divided by m. What is the new frequency? The new frequency is 1 over 2 pi under root 4k, because the spring is divided into 4 parts and one of the spring is taken. So it means that this individual spring has spring constant 4k, okay? So k is equal to 4k divided by m. Now frequency is equal to 1 over 2 pi k divided by m. When we take the under root of this 4, it will be 2 only. And we know that this one is equal to original frequency. So f naught is equal, f dash is equal to 2f. Now, if the spring is reduced to 1/4 of its initial length, then the frequency will be 2 times of the original frequency. Okay, the frequency is increased and here the time period is decreased. Okay, so the frequency will be 2 times of the original frequency. A simple pendulum has length L, has time period TE on Earth, TM on Moon, and TK at K2. Okay, Karakoram. Then the correct statement is, we know that time period is equal to 2 pi L divided by G. Look, the length is same, okay, of length L. Now, we know that gravity on Earth is greater than gravity on K2, and which is greater than gravity on Moon. Now, if we increase the gravity, the time period will decrease. Now, take the opposite of this gravity. Time period on Earth will be smaller than time period on K2, and this will be smaller than the time period on Moon. Now look at the option A. Here option A is correct, okay? If we increase the gravity, the time period will decrease. If we decrease the gravity, the time period will increase. Here the gravity is increased, so the time period is decreased. And here the gravity is decreased and the time period is increased. Look at the gravity of K2. We know that at high altitude, the gravity decreases, okay? Because gravity is inversely proportional to the radius square. So at altitude, the gravity decreases. So that's why the K2 gravity is smaller than gravity on Earth. These both are present on Earth, but this one is at high altitude and this gravity G is taken from lower altitudes, okay? This one is on the sea level. Or you can consider it as the surface of Earth, okay? Surface of Earth. And the K2 is very much high, so it means that it is considered as altitude. Now the next one, the velocity of a body executing simple harmonic motion at its mean position. We know that instantaneous velocity is equal to omega under root x naught square minus x square. If the displacement is 0, at mean position the displacement is 0. Now consider this displacement and 0, we will get under root x naught square. Or you can also write that v is equal to omega x naught. Okay. Now look at the option B. Here is the option B. So this one is the equation. Now keep one thing in your mind, that you can cancel the square and under root in that case when the two expressions are in multiplication form, okay, or division form. Now look, here it is in subtraction form, so you can't cancel these two with under root, okay, this square with under root. But look at here, now this is individual x naught, okay, so you can cancel it. But if this one is multiplication or division, then you can cancel these two, okay, you can cancel the square with under root. Now it is minus, so you can't cancel this square with under root. Keep this in your mind. The time period of a simple pendulum attached to the ceiling of a train is T. If the train accelerates suddenly, then the time period will be. Now look at here the MCQ. Let's suppose this one is a train, okay? If the train accelerates suddenly, then what will happen? Here is the pendulum and it is vibrating with a time period T. When the train accelerates, then here the acceleration, there will be two acceleration. One will be the gravity, acceleration due to gravity, and another will be acceleration due to train, okay? Now look at here, this will be like, A will be in this direction and G will be downward. If we add this one, it will be like this, and G net, the resultant will be in this direction. Now look at here, according to Pythagoras' theorem, we will add this one, okay? We will find the resultant according to Pythagoras' theorem. Now look, a square plus g square under root. We can also write it like 1 over 2. Now the expression will be time period is equal to 2 pi L divided by a square plus g square 1 over 2. Now look at here, the acceleration increases here. It means that the time period will be decreased here. Now look at the options. So when the train accelerates suddenly, then the time period will decrease. 26. The time period of simple pendulum at the center of the earth. We know that at the center of the earth, gravity is equal to 0. Then the time period will be 2 pi under root L divided by 0. So anything divided by 0 gives infinity. Okay, so the time period will be infinite. Look at 27. The time period of simple pendulum on earth is TE. The time period of same pendulum on the moon, where G on moon is G divided by 6. Now look at here. We know that time period on Earth is 2 pi L divided by G, and time period on Moon is 2 pi L divided by G, and here G is G divided by 6, okay, 1/6 of the gravity of Earth. So bring this G here, it will be like 6 L G, under root 6 L divided by G. Now take this G and write 2 pi L divided by G, okay. So we know that this one term is equal to T E, so time period on Moon is under root 6 time period on Earth. So this one is the answer. Now look at here, 28. The time period of simple pendulum in an elevator descending with 10 meter per second will be. Now look at here. We know that if a body is coming down, if an elevator is descending down, then what will happen? The net gravity will be equal to G minus acceleration, okay? But here A is equal to G. So we will write it like G minus G, okay? Then the time period will be 2 pi under root L divided by G minus G. And here we will get the answer 0, like this. Anything divided by 0 will give infinity, so it will, and when we multiply infinity with this one, so it will give the answer infinity. So now look at here, we know that total energy is equal to 1 over 2k x naught square. If we put 3 x naught square, then what you will get? 1 over 2k, 9 times of the x naught square. Now bring this 9 here, and we know that 1 over 2 x naught square is equal to et. So new energy will be equal to 9 E naught. New total energy will be equal to 9 times of the original total energy. So this one is the answer. The time period of a swing with standing person is T. If the person sit down, the time period will be. Now look at here. Here is the person standing in a swing. Okay. Now look, when a person is standing, it means that the length of the simple pendulum will be from here to here. Okay. The length will be from here, because we take the length of the simple pendulum from the center of the bob, okay? We take it from the center of the bob. So here we will consider the bob as the person, okay? We will consider the bob as person. Now we will consider the length from the center of this person to the here, okay, to the support. So the length will be L here. Now look at here, the person is sitting on a swing. When a person sit on the swing, what will happen? His center will be here, okay? Then we will consider the center from here. So look, in this case the length increases now, and we know that time period is directly proportional to the length. Now when the length increases, the time period will also increases. Now look at the options here. Option A is correct. When a person sit down, the time period will increases. So this one was the last MCQ of oscillation chapter 7. If you like the video, then share it with your friends and subscribe my channel to get the notification of next video. And if you have any problem regarding any MCQ, then write in the comment section. Allah Hafiz.